Nathan Oakley is a failed actor whose only talent is learning short sentences by heart and repeating them ad nauseam. Where's your R? That's a begging the question fallacy. Nothing is drifting away at 1,000 miles per hour on the equator. Earth isn't spinning. Meanwhile, gas doesn't go down, go boom boom. The geometric horizon we can't see and was debunked by the black swan. And more assorted nonsense. Nowadays, he has learned a new phrase. Elevation angle measurements prove Earth is flat. Or, Earth is not curved. You couldn't get an elevation angle from a curved surface. Earth has to be flat. Somehow, he cannot get it into his thick skull that the measurement of an angle in celestial navigation is totally independent of the shape of the Earth. In celestial navigation, you want to know the angle to the zenith angle. If you use a sextant, you can use a bubble sextant that gives you a horizontal baseline. You get your zenith angle by subtracting the measured elevation from 90 and you have your zenith angle. Or you can use a pendulum or gravity sextant that uses a pendulum to give you a plumb line, a true vertical against which you can read off your measured zenith angle directly. You can even get your zenith angle with the simplest of contraptions. Take a protractor, a piece of string and a small weight and you have a homemade inclinometer. It gives you the zenith angle directly. The only problem is that it is difficult to read the scale when at the same time looking at the star you are measuring, so it is more comfortable to use the theodolite app on your phone. Look along the long side of your phone to the star, make a screenshot, and there you have it, your angle to the horizontal. Subtracting it from 90 and you get your zenith angle. It doesn't matter where you are, you can stand on a steep hill, you can lie on the beach, you can sit in an airplane. You measure your angle directly in relation to the horizontal baseline. That horizontal baseline by no means requires the surface to be flat. It is even worse. When the Earth would be flat, the whole measurement brings you no closer to knowing your position. You cannot solve, using triangulation, your distance to the GP. On a spherical Earth, however, you can, because that calculation doesn't require any trigonometry and triangulation at all. It just uses the 60 nautical miles per degree formula, a formula that cannot work on a flat Earth. However, if you look closely to the screen of your phone, you can see that in the upper left-hand corner, your position in degrees latitude and longitude are shown. How lovely is the GPS, that by the way works with satellites in space, because in the middle of the ocean there are no cell towers. But hey, then Oakley just produced another standard phrase of his. Outer space is fake, you can't have gas pressure without a container. If the sky was a vacuum, the gas we breathe would fill the space. Nathan Oakley is a failed actor and a bad one at that. The only thing he can show is his utter stupidity. Combined with his extreme arrogance, it can lead to only one conclusion. Nathan Oakley is the textbook example of Dunning-Kruger.